प्रौढशाला संस्कृतव्याकरणकक्षायां सर्वेषां स्वागतम्। अद्यतनविषयः अस्ति कृदन्ताः। सो अट् द एण्ड् आफ् दिस् लेसन् वी विल् बी एबल् टु लर्न् वाट् इस् अ कृदन्त, क्यारेक्टरिस्टिक्स् आफ् ए कृदन्त, टैप्स् आफ् कृदन्त एण्ड् सम् आफ् देर् एक्साम्पल्स्। दिस् इस् अन् इन्ट्रोडक्टरी लेसन् आफ् कृदन्त। सो आल् आफ् अस् नो दट् root form of a verb is called as dhatu. When krit pratyaya is added to dhatu, a kridanta is formed. So what is a kridanta? When a set of pratyayas called krit pratyayas are added to the dhatu, a new type of word is formed, which is called kridanta. Now these kridantas are namapadas. After the addition of krit pratyas, they become pratipadika. So what is the meaning of pratipadika? The root form of a noun. So what essentially happens is, when a set of krit pratyaya is added to the dhatu, it gets converted to the root form of a noun. So when it gets converted to the root form of a noun, then we can add the pratyas related to the noun forms, and we get a subanta or a namapada. This has to be understood very carefully. So the process of, so we use krit pratyaya to convert the dhatu to a pratipadika. Why do we need to do that? So that we can use the pratipadika in different contexts. That is, we can use vibhakti pratyas and we can use in sentences very easily. So the krit, so what is krit? Krit is a set of pratyas. They are a set of suffixes. How many set of suffixes are there? About 140 plus suffixes are there in Paninian Ashtadhyayi. The definition of kridanta is that which has krit at its end. Krit ante yasya saha kridantaha. Now these krit pratyas are added to the dhatus. We also know that to the dhatus, ting pratyas are also added, which we have already studied, wherein we get forms like patati, patataha, patanti. All those forms we are getting in different lakaras, etc. These kridantas, they now become pratipadikas. All kridantas are pratipadikas. Now since they become pratipadikas, when we add supratyaya to the pratipadika, they become subantas. So essentially, we are creating a subanta from a dhatu by the addition of krit pratyaya. Now, why do we need kridanta? The kridantas, they occur in different meanings. They occur in different meanings and different contexts. And they are very useful for sentence construction, for conveying the bhava, for communicating very clearly. Sometimes these kridantas, they come in the meaning of karta. They come in the meaning of karma. They come in the meaning of bhava. They actually talk about relationship between two verbs. They act as conjunctions. They act as conjunctions. They join two actions done by the same person. So there are different applications of these kridantas. Let us learn them one by one, and whatever is essential kridantas that are required for day-to-day sentence construction. So in this course, we will be touching on the following krit pratyas. So we'll be touching on bhutakalartha krit pratyas. So they are ta, tavatu. There are two pratyas, krit pratyas, ta and tavatu, which denote past tense. So we will be learning that in this class. Example, gam dhatuhu, kta. If you add kta pratyaya to it, it will become, in pullinga, it will become gataha. If you add tavatu pratyaya, in pullinga, it will become gatavan. Gatavan, went. Gataha, also went, but it has a different connotation. So we will be learning about ta tavatu pratyaya, which denote past tense, and which is Bhutakala Artha. The second set of pratyas that we'll be learning will be the Vartamana Kala Artha pratyas. Those pratyas which denote present tense. They are the Shatru and Shanach pratya. So these are Shatru and Shanach. Example for Gam Dhatu, we have Gachan in Pullinga. For Shanach pratya, we have Labhamanaha. Now these are used in the sense of present tense. We will also be learning Kridanta Avyayas. Now there are a set of pratyas which become avyayas when added to the dhatu. Dhatu plus certain set of krit pratyas will result in avyayas as the final form. Those three or four pratyas, Tva, Lyap, Tumun and Namul. Four pratyas we'll be studying and they are Kridanta Avyayas. Example, Gatva, Gam Dhatu if you take, Gatva, Sangamya, Lep Pratyaya, Gantum, Tumun Pratyaya, Gantum. So these are the forms that we will be studying in Kridanta Avyayas. The next set of pratyas that we'll be learning are the Vidyarthaka pratyas. We have Tavya, Aniyar, Tavyat, Tavya. They are the same pratyaya. Aniyar and Ya. They denote the imperative mood. Just like Lot Lakara and Vidhiling Lakara. Gantavyaha, Gamaniyaha, Gam Dhatuhu. Gantavyaha, Gamaniyaha. Should go. One should go. Gamaniyaha. Same. One should go. Now, these are the krit pratyas that we will be studying in this course. So, the pratyas that we will be studying are Thak Tavattu, which denote past tense, Shatri Shanach, which denotes Vartamana Kala or present tense, Tavyat, Aniyar and Ya, which denotes imperative mood, and Kridanta Vyas, Tva, Lep and Tumun. So, 3 plus 3, 6 plus 2, 8 plus 2, 10. We will be studying about 10 pratyas. Tavya, Taniyar and Ya, they mean the same. We will be studying that. So about 10 pratyas, 9 to 10 pratyas we'll be studying in this course out of the 140 pratyas that we need to know. And these are very important pratyas for sentence construction at the beginner level. Let us do some exercises. Pragya.
Mithya.
Mithya. Pratipadikam plus krit pratyaya is mrithya. Is kridantam, it is mithya. Dhanyavadaha. Neel Shetty. Kridantam subantancha samane.
Kridantam subantancha samane. This is also mithya, sir.
Mithya, very good.
Dhanyavadaha.
Dhanyavada. Ravi Kiranjha. Krityasya ante tat kridantam.
Satyam.
Sarve kridantaha pratipadika samyakaha bhavanti.
Satyam.
Astu, dhanyavadaha.
Dhanyavada.
Tadvai adarsh.
Tamra.
Krit yojanena dhatuhu pratipadikam bhavati.
Satyam.
Kridanta rupanam trayaha purushaha bhavanti.
Mithya.
Very good. So, when this is the very important point about kridanta. So when we add krit pratyaya, it becomes pratipadika, the dhatu becomes pratipadika. And after it becomes pratipadika, we need not worry about prathama purusha, madhyama purusha, uttama purusha, just like the lakara forms that we were worried about. We need to worry about the vibhaktis and the vibhakti pratyas, the lingas, especially pullinga, strilinga, napumsakalinga. So in kridanta, we worry about the lingas. We think in which linga, how we have to use. Whereas in the lakara rupas, ting rupas, we worry about the purushas. So in kridanta rupas, purushas will not come. So it is mithya. That this answer is mithya. This is a very important point that we have to understand. Vartamanarthe taktavatu pratyau upayuktau bhavataha. Devika Ravi.
Mithya.
Mithya. What is the pratya used for vartamana?
Vartamana is Shatru Shanach.
Shatru Shanach Pratyaya. Very good. Kridanta avyayam nama kridantam api bhavati avyayam api bhavati. Radhika Raghavan.
नमस्ते महोदय.
सत्यं वा? अस्तु
सत्यं.
सो कृदन्तव्यास् मीन्स् दे आर् आल्सो कृदन्तास्. सो आफ्टर् दे बिकम् प्रातिपदिक अगेन् सुप्रत्यया कम्स् बट् द सुप्रत्यया गेट्स् लोप एस् पर् अव्यया रूल्. सो द सुप्रत्यया इस् नाट् सीन् इन् आल् द विभक्तीस् हेन्स् दे बिकम् अव्यास्. सो कृदन्तव्यास् फस्ट् दे विल् बिकम् सुबन्तास् देन् अगेन् दे विल् बिकम् प्रातिपदिकास् सुप्रत्यास् दे कम् बट् दे वेनिश् एस् पर् द avyaya rule and they finally become avyayas. Dhanyavadah. So dhatu plus krit. Ram Babu Mahodaya.
Krudanta.
Dhatu plus krit. Dash pratyo vidyarte bhavatah. Tavyat aniyar. Dhanyavadah.
Tavyat aniyar.
Dash kalam dyotaitum shatru shanach upayuktav. Can you answer this?
Shatru shanach.
Which kala it denotes?
Vartamana kala.
वर्तमानकालं द्योतयितुं. वेरि गुड्. भूतकालं द्योतयितुं डाश् कृत् प्रत्ययौ प्रयुज्येते.
तावत्
तक् तवतु. वेरि गुड्. त्वा तुमुन् ल्यप् प्रत्ययानां योजनेन कृदन्तं किं भवति?
इण्डिक्लैनबल्स्.
अव्ययं भवति. अव्ययं भवति. सो दिस् वास् स्माल् इन्ट्रोडक्षन् अबौट् कृदन्तास्.